6.
Your big story at 6. Some protesters say animals are dying in Lee County that shouldn't be and don't have to. Thanks for watching The Station, where you always get more. I'm Jeff Butero.
And I'm Jeff Harrison for Krista Fogelsong tonight. A rescue group wants the shelter to do more to give animals a chance to find a new home. ABC 7's Joshua Cole gets us more on this controversy.
Rescue group Urgent Dogs and Cats of Lee County wants it to be easier for them and other groups to know if an animal is at risk of being put down so they can save it.
The dogs are the victims, and when they're not able to be pulled because other dogs are not adopted, the dogs pay with their life at Lee County Domestic Animal Services.
Miranda Wyatt with her co-founder Melissa York of Urgent Dogs and Cats says they want better answers for where animals end up before euthanasia is an option.
We have to be able to know where these dogs went so that people can adopt them and get them out of the rescues so that the rescues can pull more dogs.
The county posts their monthly intake numbers online. Just this year, helping more than 500 animals in January and February. Of those, just over 159 animals were euthanized in those 2 months. Lee County officials say they have to take in any animal. Not all are adoptable because of injuries or they're too sick. The county says it's at the state average and above several Florida counties for finding animals' homes. This graph from the county shows euthanasia rates, shown in light blue, have decreased. Most were adopted, returned to their owner, released, or sent to one of more than 60 other rescues the county works with.
What we need is for Lee County to tell the general public where the dogs went once they're out of the building, who pulled the dogs.
Joshua Cole reporting.